Well, the hydrogen atom, you know, it's a part of a fusion process.
Mm-hmm.
It works on a, you know, they're still trying to get cold fusion going on. It's a big joke in the physics community, and anybody that tries it's like risking their reputation to being, you know, committed for cold fusion. But the closest you could explain this is the cold fusion process.
Mm-hmm.
The actual energy transfer takes place in the hydrogen atom of the person that's wearing it. And this if you get into a platinum receptor, it will raise your blood pressure. But it won't raise the diastolic pressure, which is the return. It will raise mm-hmm. the systolic pressure, which is the pressure going out of the heart. But the pressure
right.
coming back, which is the critical one, would cause a heart attack if you were to get blocked. That will actually lower. It actually maintains a low level, like 120 over 70, for example. It would be the 70.
So the platinum in the receptor would kind of be like a catalyst.
Yeah, exactly. And it really produces like a cold fusion effect on the hydrogen atom. But you have to have something like the body. Now, some people will heat up. Their body temperature will rise a little bit when they wear the platinum receptor. It's the one that's most noticeable to the human body for this kind of work. The gold one increases circulation and increases objectivity. It relaxes. The silver one is a bit of a stimulator, but and the silver one is much more powerful than the little inexpensive zinc one that we make that's gold-plated that sells for $165.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But when you compare platinum to any of them, the platinum is where you really start seeing the nuclear work. And that's why it's called a nuclear receptor, because it works on those forces.
It's very
powerful. I bought a pound of platinum the other day just to have it around. Not only as an investment, but if I need to melt it down to make receptors, I can.
Mm.
And just holding that platinum, a big bar of it, you know, was amazing.
Oh,
I never had that much in my possession before. And then comparing it to electricity, in the solar panels today, they have the N and P junctions like a transistor, except now they're converting a photon into an electric current through an NPN junction.
Mm-hmm.
And that photon now, it's the reverse of what Einstein won a Nobel Peace Prize for back on photoelectric effect. That's what he got his Nobel Peace Prize for back in the 20s, for the photoelectric effect, where they could take and put metal out into the sun and it would produce electricity. And that was called the photoelectric effect. And that's what a solar cell is today. And so the receptor is, from a physics standpoint, producing the same effect, but it needs the hydrogen atom in the physical human body to produce the effect.
Right, notice the effect.
However, you can take a glass of grapefruit juice
mm-hmm.
and drop a receptor into it, and it will change the pH of it, indicating that it is going more towards alkalinity versus acidity. So you're getting there an electrolysis effect in the grapefruit juice.
Yeah,
it's demonstrable. You can demonstrate it in a laboratory.